On the November 4th ballot, Miami-Dade County voters will be asked to approve a $393 million bond referendum, allowing the construction of a new courthouse, something that is desperately needed. The current courthouse, which is on the National Register of Historical Places, has been in disrepair for decades, with mold, termites, and flooding listed as just a few of the many problems. But will voters agree to this new construction if it means raising property taxes? Joining me to discuss the need for a new courthouse, we welcome Bertila Soto, Chief Judge in the 11th Judicial Circuit Court of Florida. Judge, good to see you.
Good to see you. Thank you for having me.
So we know there is, well, first of all, there is a long list of problems with the courthouse.
Yes.
Why bring this issue to the voters now?
Well, we've known about the need at the courthouse for a long time, and we've been working with it. There's a 2002 study, a 2008 study, where they call for replacing of the Dade County Courthouse. But we've been working in there. But in January of this year, we received a structural report concerning the columns in the basement, saying that 132 of the 144 columns were corroded at 30 to 50%, some up to 80%. And that the slab, which is underneath the columns, was also corroded and needed to have some replacement, all to be done within the next 12 to 24 months. And we learned that there wasn't money in the budget for that, and we were concerned. So on top of having termites and water intrusion and flooding and old AC units, 35 of 51 just in the first six floors being over 60 years old, causing leaking in our ceilings every day, now we have columns that are corroded.
Well, when you look at this issue, and you say that there's no room in the budget for fixing, those issues that you've mentioned, just the columns alone, have to be fixed.
Correct.
So if you don't do this bond ref, if this bond referendum isn't successful, where does that money come from?
That's going to have to come from the county, and the county's going to have to find it. That's really not my call because we're tenants.
Because the county is constitutionally charged with providing the physical structure for the courts. The state provides the operational funds.
Correct. So the county is under a constitutional obligation to provide court facilities and maintenance. And so Dade County would be the one that would have to pay for that.
Do you have any idea how much that would be? Just to repair the columns.
Well, what we've done in this referendum is asked for $25 million to repair the columns, and then the rest of the money would go to a new building, because we understand that we'll have to be in that building. We have 576 employees. We need to remain there until they can build us a building. We need a functioning civil courthouse. Miami-Dade County has 192,000 pending civil cases, so we still need a building until we can move out. The facade is already being worked on, and the money has already been allocated for the facade, because we have water intrusion coming. When it rains in downtown, it rains inside that building. So we're confident that if we can shore up those columns, we can remain in the building 3 to 4 to 5 years to get a new one.
And ultimately, why do you need to have a new building?
Well, we've been compacted in that building for almost 20 years. When that building started, which is a beautiful building, a historic building, it's designated. It was the first courthouse I ever remember seeing. We were 7 judges. We're now 41 judges. It used to be the city offices, the county offices, and the jail. The jail left, the city left, and the county left. And now the clerk and the court lives in that building. Well, we have 41 judges for 23 courtrooms. We don't fit in that courthouse anymore. We have 1 million visitors walking through our doors. We have jurors, we have litigants, we have witnesses, people coming for different county services. And the building was never meant for that. So we have a real problem. But we live with that compacted space for a long time. But now with the column issues and the water intrusion and all the other things that are compounded, making the building unsafe and unhealthy, where we reach this crisis.
There are maybe 6 floors that are closed because of bad air quality. I mean, closed.
Closed.
Out of a 27-story building.
Actually more now, because we're going to be closing down the 9th floor.
Oh my. How can there be a certificate of occupancy for this building? It's a fire hazard, it's a health hazard. I don't get it.
That would be something you'd have to ask the county and the city. We're simply the tenants. Unfortunately, I'm not privy to that information, but
considering there are over 3,000 employees, more than 3,000 employees, that are 3,000 people who use the building every day, Monday through Friday, It just seems astounding to me that this building is operational. If it was another public building, any other public building, would it be a school? Would it be a hospital? Would it be a college? It would be closed.
That's what I asked. I said, if this were a school, would someone keep this open? But we've been told it's structurally safe, and they remediate the floors as they're told. We move our employees, we move our courtrooms, we move our staff. Our entire probate division, which deals with marchmen and baker acts and appointing of guardians and wills and testaments, very, very delicate issues with some very heated issues legally, have been moved to another facility, not a courthouse, with no walls, with cubicles, and some very difficult, sad hearings about mental health is being held without walls, where people can hear the hearings. We have white noise machines trying to stop other people in that area from hearing what's going on in the courtrooms.
So the opposition that comes is that, number one, this is thrown on the people at the last minute, and you've explained that that's not accurate. And that, number two, you have to look, or why not look, at alternative sources. Mayor Carlos Jimenez would say that there are alternative funding issues. You can raise the fees. Why not just raise the fees for the users of the court system?
Well, the filing fees are state money. We have some of the highest filing fees in the country. And we did go to Chief Justice Ricky Polston, is now Justice LaBarga, and we asked about that. And we have a constitutional right to access of courts. And he said that that money wouldn't create a funding stream for Miami-Dade County, in addition to the fact that it would be an excess fee to people trying to use the court system. So we looked at then parking tickets. That wasn't a sufficient funding stream. We looked at actually traffic tickets. And we already assess a certain amount of money on traffic tickets. And if we were to look at traffic tickets and add more money, it would be another $37 to $48 a ticket. And that would be extremely high. We already have a big problem with driving while license suspended in Miami-Dade County. And it was a decision that wasn't something we wanted to do. It would be a tax. It would cost somebody $47 more. This is only $14 a year to the average homeowner. And although we don't like asking that, I think it's a little different than putting that on the driver.
There's also suggestions that perhaps what you could do is use other facilities, maybe divide the court so that perhaps you can use a Hialeah court, a different location. What's wrong with that?
Well, we do have satellite courts that actually work with local areas. We have one in North Dade, one in South Dade, and the Gables. They're very small. They're meant for traffic tickets and non-jury trials. The civil courthouse has the most jury trials in Dade County, believe it or not. And those facilities are not equipped with jury pools, jury rooms, or jury boxes. We would have to pull all the jurors in the criminal courthouse if the civil courthouse closed. And we wouldn't be able to get enough. We then would have to bus them to the satellites. And that would be definitely not efficient.
Those who are naysayers are concerned that the previous bond money that was issued to repair the structure 10 years ago wasn't used for that. The county commission, which is in charge of those funds, allocated, instead of taking care of plumbing, for example, right, allocated it for facade. How can a voter ensure that this time it would be different?
Well, here's the thing. What happened with the facade was it was cracking. It was really in bad shape in 2009 and starting in 2007. And there was money for AC and electrical that was in the Building Better Bonds money. And the complete overhaul of the electrical and plumbing can't really be done while we're in the courthouse. So it was sitting there. And they were using it and fixing things, but not what they wanted to do. So it was there, and when the facade became such an issue, where it was literally raining inside the floors, where there was flooding, where they had to remediate the 22nd, 23rd, 14th, and 15th floor at a cost to the taxpayers, they decided to repurpose that money and use it for the facade. And so I think that was a good use of the money.
There is a call to have an oversight board to oversee the funds should voters approve this initiative. How would that work?
It's actually went in front of the commission this Tuesday, and it passed, and it has a second reading. And what it's going to be, each commissioner will have an appointee. I will have an appointee. The state attorney will have an appointee, and the clerk, and the mayor. and it, I believe it's 17 people, and they will decide how the money is spent and watch the project, very similar to what the school board has done, which I applaud their efforts in being transparent, and they deal with issues, and people can go to them. There have been issues, and they deal with them, and I think that that's a good way. I understand. I'm a taxpayer. I live in Dade County, and I'm concerned about how we spend our money. And so we want to be as transparent as possible.
Judge, your position as Chief Justice is to manage the system. Is that, I don't want to say that you're an office manager, but you're a manager for, you're the spokesperson for this project representing the courts.
Correct. We're 123 judges. I'm at the, we're all the same constitutional officers. We're state employees. And I was elected by my colleagues, and I basically work with administration. I do have some cases, but for the most part, I administer all the court system and all of its staff and deal with issues that come to the courthouse.
What is the biggest myth regarding this issue that really bothers you?
Well, I think what really bothers me is this is not a political issue. This is something for the people. This is important. This is part of being an American. This is the third branch of government. We won't have a functioning government if we don't have a justice system. This isn't just for rich lawyers. These are for people like you and me that one day may have a parent who passes away and you need a will or you need a guardian for an elderly parent. You have a small claims case. You have a foreclosure. We had the biggest foreclosure crisis in the state of Florida. We're the biggest circuit in the state of Florida, one of the largest in the country. This building does a lot of good service to Miami. We are proud of being an international city. We need to be proud of our court system. So I can't imagine anyone not saying that this is important to Dade County.
Chief Judge Bertila Soto, thanks so much for joining me today on Issues.
Thank you very much.